Welcome back again, Vishal Kumar Srivastava again in front of you. Today we are going to discuss the plant cell. दोस्तों पिछले वीडियो में मैंने प्रोकैरियोटिक सेल के बारे में डिस्कस किया था, उसके बाद मैंने बताया था कि मैं यूकैरियोटिक सेल्स के बारे में डिस्कस करूंगा, तो आज चलते हैं यूकैरियोटिक प्लांट सेल के बारे में डिस्कस करते हैं। यूकैरियोटिक प्लांट सेल, यूकैरियोटिक मींस द कंप्लीट न्यूक्लियस, द सेल हैव कंप्लीट न्यूक्लियस, इट्स कॉल्ड यूकैरियोटिक सेल एंड वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द प्लांट सेल। What is plant cell? Plant cell is found inside the plant, as you know the name of the plant cell. Or this is the cell. This is the cell discovered by Robert Hooke in 1665 with the cork cadmium. Now we are going to make a structure of plant cell. Structure of plant cell. Structure of plant cell. This is the outermost layer of plant cell known as cell wall. Cell wall, the outermost layer of plant cell, or the covering of plant cell made up of cellulose and pectin. And the secondary layer is present between the cell wall and cell membrane. This is the cell membrane or plasma membrane of plant cell. And the middle layer, which is found between the cell wall and cell membrane, is known as middle lamina. This is middle lamina. This is cell membrane, the outermost covering of the animal cell or the covering portion of the each cell or every cell, which is called the plasma, and various type of cell organelles inside the cell. Now we are going to discuss the vacuole. This is vacuole. Vacuole means the empty portion present inside the cell, which maintain the turgidity or turbidity of cell in the case of osmosis and diffusion. Now this is the nucleus. Nucleus contains the nuclear material and chromatin net, and the central part of the nucleus known as nucleolus. Nucleolus, and this structure is known as nucleus. And the nucleus is made up by the membrane known as nuclear membrane. Nuclear membrane. And inside the nucleus, the nucleoplasm is present. Nucleoplasm and the chromatin thread. यानी कि ये जो thread like structure है, ये है DNA thread और chromatin thread. Chromatin thread present inside the nucleus. This is Golgi apparatus or Golgi bodies. Golgi bodies or Golgi apparatus, which is known as the traffic place of the cell, discovered by Camillo Golgi, which is maintained or regulate the properties of transfer the materials inside the cell or outside the cell and the recognition portions. This is known as endoplasmic reticulum, or in short it is known as ER. There are two types of endoplasmic reticulum, SER and the second one is RER. What is SER? S stands for the smooth. smooth endoplasmic reticulum, and I stand for the rough endoplasmic reticulum. Why we say that rough? Due to the presence of ribosome on the surface of or the surface of endoplasmic reticulum. These ribosomes help in the protein synthesis. That is why this site is known as a protein synthesis site inside the cell. And this site is known as lipid synthesis site. The smooth endoplasmic reticulum is responsible for the lipid synthesis and also the production of antitoxin chemical inside the cell, which help in the various type of removal of toxins. Now, the plasma present inside the cell known as cytoplasm inside the cell, the plasma inside the cell, the lipid material inside the cell, except the cell organelle, and this is the known as mitochondria is the plural name, the similar is mitochondrium. This is known as the powerhouse of the cell. The energy is stored in the mitochondria in the form of ATP, adenosine triphosphate. Now this cell organelle known as chloroplast present inside the plant cell, which help to photosynthesize the cell. The plant cell photosynthesis process performed by the chloroplast. The chloroplast contains thylakoid and different types of chlorine and magnesium molecule. Now, this is the ribosome. Before this video, I will tell you there are two types of ribosome present on the basis of prokaryotic and eukaryotic. In this cell, in this eukaryotic cell, ATS type of ribosomes are present. ATS, S stands for the Swedberg unit. Ribosomal structure is known as protein synthesis structure, and in this it is have two subunits, 60 plus 40. The largest subunit is 60 and the smallest subunit is 40. Then why should we have had this AT? Because suppose this is the ATS ribosome and this is the this is 60S and this is 40S. When both are adjoined to each other, some portion of 60S is added in the 40S, and this structure is complete and the total unit is 80S. Now, this cell is discovered by Robert Hooke in 1665. The plant cell have the structure like a honeycomb, and these middle lamella is adjacent join the next cell and this form the tissues by the middle lamella. This middle lamella is made up of the very usable and perfect chemicals. I will tell you the name of the chemical in the next sessions. These chemicals bind the whole cells to each other and form a complete tissue or organ of the plant. Thank you. Milte next video.